It figures to be a wet one, but we'll have baseball for you on MLB Network nonetheless. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Philadelphia Phillies and the New York Mets. Hello again, everybody. Baseball is back. Welcome to our special opening day broadcast on MLB Network. I'm joined by Dan Plesac. And Dan, as we get things going this season, it's pitching that has to be key if this team's going to have success.
Hey, just like any team, pitching is going to be the key factor for this ball club as the year plays out. I'm sure the staff will have its ups and downs, but putting together some quality outings early in the season could do wonders for this club getting out of the gate with a good start.
The games count starting now. Opening day on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Getting close to first pitch here. Let's listen in to public address announcer Alex Miniak.
Ladies and gentlemen, your New York Mets.
Quickly now, a look at the two men who are entrusted with the starting pitching assignment here to begin the new year. Time now for a glance at the Phillies batting order in this one. Mark, what do you have on this lineup as they go for their first win?
Matty, you take a look at this lineup. I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one. Here's the defensive alignment for the New York Metropolitans. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
Stepping up now, Aaron Bailey. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Aaron Bailey.
One.
For a base hit here as he gets this one down. To first. Wow.
Well, you know, he had a good idea right there. The infield was playing back, but it's not going to work out for him this time. That's a nice play to react, and they take care of him at first.
So striding forward now, number 87. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he fouls this one off. Liner towards second. But this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it to end the inning. Down in order go the Mets. We are still scoreless. As we begin the second in New York, here's Heidi Watney with an update on the weather conditions.
Well, Matt, the grounds crew members that I talked to prior to the game said the weather we're experiencing right now is expected to move on as the game progresses. They said they'll put extra effort into keeping the field dry until this rain dies down. But despite it being a little wet at the moment, we should get this one in uninterrupted.
Now at the plate, number 87, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First pitch coming. Here it is. Swing and a drive. Now to get that one, you'll need a 50-foot ladder to make the catch. A no-doubt home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. First home run of the campaign for him. And they cut the gap here. It's now 6-4. Certainly a tape measure shot there as we take a look at it with our show track technology. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity, so it comes as no surprise that it carried as far as it did. Now at the plate, number 87. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gone.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Matty, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile. But, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. On drive, base hit to right. The cash in here as the run is in to score from third. It's now an 8-6 game. And no chance there. He'll make it to third safely.
Boy, this guy's having a great game here so far, D-Row. Home run earlier in the night, right, and that base hit right there drives in his third run batted in of this game.
Yeah, you drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup, and that's exactly been the case today. He not only mixed in that big bomb, but now he's got three ribbies to boot.
Yeah, I think it's pretty clear they don't want to challenge this guy right here, but working around a guy can come back to bite you at times.
This one's down to third.
Hernan.
Right there. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. Now at the plate, Merrill Doss, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Merrill Doss.
Boy, not close again. His third walk of the inning as that misses for ball four.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Here now is Jake Bowers. Two hits and two trips for him thus far.
Jake Bowers.
And a double steal try here. Weakly
run,
hit to third.
He's got it.
Throw in time for the third out, but it certainly took a while as the inning is finally over. All in all, 10 men come to the plate and five score. On to the top of inning number five we go. The Mets lead this one 9-6. So striding in, Pedro Fernandez, 0-2 here to start the afternoon. Ready to deal, here's the 2-1. Hit on the ground to third, fielded cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Number 87 will stride in, but first we take you back to the third as you take another look here at his two-run homer that had him rolling early on. First pitch of the at-bat. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Into the upper deck, but foul. High in the air out towards shallow right. Sanchez is going to get there. Two down. Coming to the plate now, number 87. He went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point. Thank you.
Here comes the first pitch. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. You can kiss it goodbye. Solo shot to right center. His second home run of the game as they jump ahead by three. Guys, we've seen four big balls between the two teams so far today. What are your impressions of the long ball display we're watching? Now batting, Ross Jack. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, pressure's off right now. He extended his hitting streak that last plate appearance. Now he gets to get back into his zone and try and drive something in the gap.
Throw on first is going to be in time to get him, and the Mets move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over.
Well, that's not exactly how you draw it up. He gave up a long ball to make it interesting, but it was the only run he gave up, and he hangs on to collect the save.
This one wraps up as a 10-8 final. The Metropolitans took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Tim Palacios claimed the win out of the pen, his first. Diego Olivo was slapped with 8 earned runs as he takes the loss. Victor Sanchez records the save, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB.